Hey, folks, it's Lindsey Hollis with SPS back in the building over at the Horatio Williams Foundation. Day two of the team basketball camp is hosted here at University of Detroit Mercy. And I'm sitting here with one of the winning coaches having some success today. And let's just face it, having some success overall is Birmingham Brother Rice's Rick Palmer. Coach, how you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Great. It's always a pleasure to sit down with you, man. We have fun on the camera and off camera. But it's June. You got your guys in a historic University of Detroit Mercy gym for a team camp with your guy Horatio Williams. How you feeling right now?
Feeling good. I like our group. We've got a lot of guys back. We've got some new faces too, and some guys ready to step into bigger roles. So
yeah, you know, I was thinking time. About that as we talked when we started running down rosters and what's going on, who's new. You seem to have this consistent ability along with keeping the players you have, but always being able to infuse some new players. Also kind of some kids with some names because of the pedigree. Why do you think you have become a destination for a lot of high-profile athletes to be able to come and transition with you and your program?
I mean, I think Brother Rice, first off, is a special place. There's a lot of really good things going on there. We got the largest incoming class at Brother Rice that we've had in decades. So there's over 200 young men coming into school in general. So I think there's a lot of excitement about Brother Rice. Obviously, being a member of the Catholic League, people say this and they get mad, but it's the best league in the state. Just top to bottom, at night in, night out. So it gets the most exposure, it gets the most coverage. It's got high-level coaches, high-level players, and a lot of guys want to play and compete against the best. So we offer that opportunity to the other teams in our league. And then, you know, I think we will see our skill development and some of the things. Yeah, we've had some high-level guys that walked in high-level, but we've also had some guys that have become high-level once after being in our program. So we've got guys, two guys we just graduated weren't household names, and they're both getting college paid for. So I think we offer a lot of things, and I think I like to think of myself as a coach that's not hard to play for, demanding, but also let you do your thing. I'm trying to make it about the kids, and I think that, honestly, I think that's what helps.
Yeah. So I can appreciate that. That's a great answer. How do you measure success in June?
Just individual, like, development. I've said this before, but I played for Kirk Keener and worked for him, longtime legendary coach of Country Day, and, the summer was never about wins and losses. And every program does different things. You see some teams here are, it's all about trying to win that game, and I appreciate that. They have a philosophy that in the summer you just got to develop that winning culture all the time. I've got the philosophy that the wins and losses don't matter as much, and let's try to develop players. And so we've got a big roster this summer. We've got a lot of guys that need varsity minutes, and you see, like, today we had five different guys that played, and yesterday they didn't, and then tomorrow, so we had about 16 guys that are going to play in the 3 days, and everybody's going to play too, and everybody's going to have a day off. And I'd just rather keep the rosters a little smaller and really make sure guys get a chance to play and develop, and not be as concerned about just playing some, I know what Dave Williams is going to be able to do. Can we develop some other guys and put them in different situations and see what they can do? So that, for me, is my philosophy, and not my Coach Keener's philosophy that I've just stolen. So
you're becoming the caretaker of. That is great, man. Guys getting up and down, man. How would you describe this team, this roster, even though we are talking about June basketball? How would you profile your team right now if you had to describe it?
I think first and foremost, we've got a great group of guys. I said that last year. It's the most enjoyable team I've ever coached. And Warren and Luke are great kids, but we've got still all those same great kids here and more great ones coming in. When your best player is Elijah Williams, and he's just such a coachable, great kid, star, everybody else kind of can just fall in line.
Yeah, and he's such a pleasure to watch, too. Yeah.
And it's been nice. He's at the USA tryouts. He's down to the 18 guys for 12 spots. He's to the final cut today and tomorrow, the last day.
Uh-huh.
So hopefully he's, Trey McKinney and Cheeks just did a great job representing our country, and I hope Elijah can be on the next younger team and do the same thing those guys did. So it's been nice much as we love to have them,
uh-huh.
you know, it's not having them has made other guys have to do
yeah, refreshing, giving them that chance.
And giving them a chance. So,
being a USA basketball family member, if you will, appreciate that. I would say from my experience watching Elijah, watching you guys, despite his namesake and his pedigree, that kid is deserving. That kid puts in the work. I mean, despite what his lineage is, it's like he gets out there and he gets it done and makes other people play too.
And listen, if you looked at the roster of that USA team, there's a lot of guys with lineage. There's a lot of now NBA players with kids, former NBA players whose kids have made a name for themselves and can play. So, you know, if he makes it, it won't be because of his dad.
Right.
There's guys who have really high-level dads that got cut yesterday. So, you know, if Elijah makes it, which I know it's been a huge goal for him, he was close last year, and it's kind of been a driving force. So I'm really hoping he gets that done.
Yeah, we'll keep a positive attitude. Coach, you're doing good. Are you done for the day? Was this your third game?
We are done for the day.
Yeah,
We're
you take a break, and I know you're heading out next week. You'll be going up to B-Cam, I would imagine.
Yeah, we got one at Groves tomorrow.
That's right. Over to see Derek Coleman.
We don't really have numbers yet, but we had some of our main guys played both today, or yesterday and yesterday, so they're all going to be off tomorrow. We'll have all our young guys. We'll play a really good team, King, tomorrow. So we want to keep putting our guys in situations to get really challenged. And if they screw up, great. It's the summer. Like, it's hard to let guys play through mistakes in the winter in our league, in our schedule. We don't have any cupcakes. So, to have these in the summer is important. If guys make mistakes, hopefully they learn from them and coach them up.
And learn from them again right there. Yeah. Well, you're doing it, man. Always a pleasure. Enjoy it. Want you to be able to enjoy the rest of this evening, and I'm sure we'll be sitting down soon.
All right.
I appreciate you.
Thank you.
All right, guys.
Thanks.
With that being said, this is Lindsay Ellis with SPS. See you next time. Peace. Do what I should, man.